much-awaited tell-all book from President Trump's niece, Mary Trump. It's going to be hitting bookshelves 2 weeks earlier than expected. The Trump family had sued to stop the publication. Well, now CNN has seen a copy. Let me bring in CNN's Sarah Murray. Sarah, what can you tell us about this?
Kate, we did just get a copy of the book. It's a pretty slim 14-chapter read, but it is quite the indictment of President Trump from a member of his own family. You know, we haven't heard a lot from the direct members of the Trump family. This is a book that is coming from Mary Trump, who is his niece. It is a book that one of the president's siblings has actually tried to block from publishing, but the publisher got the release to go forward. And, you know, we're looking through some of these things, and in it you see Mary Trump writing about the hubris of her uncle. She writes about how she didn't actually think that he was taking his presidential election seriously. And she even had lunch at one point with Marianne Trump, Marianne Barry Trump, who was a federal judge. And they're discussing Donald Trump running for president. This is back in 2016. And it recounts this conversation in which Marianne Trump says, "He's a clown." This is what the book said. "He's a clown," my Aunt Marianne said during one of our regular lunches at the time. "This will never happen." Now, Mary Trump is someone who has had a very fraught history with other members of her family. There was a big fight after the patriarch of this family died over essentially Donald Trump and his siblings trying to cut Mary Trump and her brother out of the will. So there's been bad blood in this family for a long time. She also makes it very clear in the book that she was no fan of the possibility of her uncle winning the presidency. She said she got invited to Donald Trump's election night party, and she turned down the invitation because she thought it would be rude if she was out there celebrating Hillary Clinton's victory. Now, obviously, that's not how it panned out. And she writes in the book that she stayed silent for a long time when Donald Trump won the presidency and when he's been in office, but she just felt like she was sitting by and watching her uncle ruin the country. And she writes in her book that she could not stand by and be silent any longer. Now, there's a reason that this book is coming from Simon Schuster, and you're not seeing Mary Trump on television right now doing a bunch of interviews. And that's because, as of right now, there's still a temporary restraining order against Mary Trump that's blocking her from being able to talk about her own book. The restraining order against the publisher, though, was lifted, and that's why we're starting to see these copies come out, Kate.
And you were hitting on it right there. But of course, a big question in everyone's mind is how much detail does she go into her relationship with Donald Trump, but also why she's writing this book, what she wants to come out of it.
Right. Well, of course, we're still a team at CNN is still reading through it because we just got our hands on it this morning. And it's a quick read, but it's hard for one person to digest all at once. But, you know, I think there are a couple things going on here. I mean, one is that there's certainly bad blood within the ranks of the Trump family, as there was with this lawsuit, you know, 20 years ago, this litigation mm-hmm. that happened over the will of Fred Trump. You know, the other thing is that she writes in her book that she's really offended by the way that President Trump invoked her father's memory. Her father was named Fred Trump, and he died, and he suffered with alcoholism. And she said she watched the way Donald Trump used her father's story to relate to people who were dealing with the opioid crisis. And she just felt that her father's memory was being used for political purposes. She writes in the book that Marianne Trump Barry, again, the former federal judge, also agreed with that and was also offended with that assessment. So that's part of what's playing into this. And then, you know, she makes it very clear, as I said, that she did not want Donald Trump to win the presidency. She was an avid Hillary Clinton supporter. And she writes that she sort of felt that she stayed silent for long enough, and that as she's been watching the things that have happened throughout her uncle's presidency, she just felt like she had to come forward and she had to speak up. Now, this may be the first time that we're seeing her sort of put her face and her name to these words, but we have heard from her without realizing before. You know, she writes in her book and confirms right. that she was a source for that big New York Times investigation into the Trump family taxes that really sort of alleged that a lot of what they were doing was not up to par, and that they, you know, may have misstated some things in their finances over the years and may have even committed fraud. And it's interesting because now her lawyers are using that as a reason that she should not be silenced. They're saying, look, this settlement agreement she signed 20 years ago was all based on fraudulent information. You should throw it out the window.
And that still continues. Right, Sarah, continue reading, but stick with me if you could, please. Let me bring in Chief Media Correspondent Brian Stelter with more on this. Brian, you were just reporting on how, because of demand, that this publishing date was even moved up.
That's right, and that's why these copies are starting to leak out. Here's one of the many copies that's already been shipped out to bookstores. This book is essentially an anti-Trump campaign book, Kate. From my initial read of it, Joe Biden couldn't have written a more effective book against the president of the United States. But you say that, you know, I say it's like an anti-Trump campaign book, but it's coming from inside the family. There's never been anything like this in modern political history to have the niece of a president write a scathing tell-all. Let me just read a couple of the parts that stand out to me, Kate, from the very end of the book, talking about the president's cruelty, saying the cruelty is the point, which is a quote from the Atlantic writer Adam Serwer. It goes on to say that the cruelty serves as a means to distract both us and himself from the true extent of his failures. She writes at the end of the book, we must dispense with the idea of Donald being a strategically brilliant person understanding media and politics. He doesn't have a strategy, Mary says. He never has. She says it was a fluke that he won the election. She says he never thought that he was going to win. And that he takes these rebukes as challenges and doubles down on his behavior because of these problems in his family that she describes in detail, as Sarah just mentioned. At the end of the book, Kate, you know, what you hear from Mary Trump is that, you know, it's a lifetime of failures by the president of the United States. She says the lies may become true in his mind as soon as he utters them, but they are still lies. It's just another way for him to see what he can get away with. And so far, he's gotten away with everything. This is the ultimate disappointed relative. You know, you think about any family drama, you times it by 1,000, and that's what you get with this book by Mary Trump.
But you hit on it. We'll continue to go through, of course, and everyone will read the quotes and we'll, of course, wait to hear how the president responds if he does and all of that. But just to sit for a second and absorb the fact that this is a scathing rebuke hitting at all of the major sensitivity points that we know of Donald Trump, and it's coming from his own family. I mean, coming from his niece, that he's a clown is how Sarah Marie says it's described in a conversation in the book. And as you say, when you talk about failures and the fact that he didn't have a strategy and it's a fluke, it is sad to see to read this.
The reason I say sad, you know, here's page 202. Donald continues to exist in the dark space between the fear of indifference and the fear of failure that led to his brother's destruction. She goes on to say, every time you hear Donald talking about how something is the greatest, the best, the biggest, the most tremendous, you have to remember that the man speaking is still, in essential ways, the same little boy who is desperately worried that he, like his older brother, is inadequate, and that he, too, will be destroyed for his inadequacy. At a very deep level, this is Mary Trump, his bragging and false bravado are not directed at the audience in front of him, but at his audience of one, his long-dead father. So ultimately, Mary Trump is saying it all comes back to those daddy issues, challenges, struggles.
Well, and you know, Brian.
And I think, frankly, many people can relate to that, Kate. Many people have their own family issues, but to see it unspooled in a book about the president is astonishing.